Hi all. So in the previous session, we have discussed about the computer networks, how it works, what are the uses of computer network, and what are the advantages of computer network. And in this session, we are going to discuss the types of network, the categories available as network, just like LAN, WAN, MAN. So let us discuss all these points in this session. Then we have some networking devices like switches, hubs, repeaters, like all these, and also WAP system. So we can discuss all these topic and also the exercise portion of this chapter.
Types of networks. The types of networks. So we all are connected to the networks with our computer, with our mobile phone, with our devices and all. So the computer networks can be classified based on size, transmission technology used, data transfer speed, connections, etc. Networking can be wired or wireless. You can see the mouse or the devices, keyboard, everything wired. And also you can see the same thing which is unwired. So all these things are possible in this era. And we can classify the things, the categories of networks like three main classifications. First one is LAN. Second one is MAN. Third one, WAN. What is that actually? LAN means it is local area network. LAN stands for local area network. Just you have to imagine that you are sitting in an office or you are going to your school. In that location, your devices are connected to a single building itself. Right? To a proper range, to a proper area or a proper building only. So that is actually considered as a LAN network. So we can easily say that the LAN means it is network created within a small geographic area. Within a small geographic area like an organization, a building, a campus, like all these. And in this case, the size is limited, like a few hundred meters and not more than a mile. We can consider it as an organization, building, campus, etc. Then we can have the example of LAN. You can see the example of LAN in the same screen. We are connecting some devices to a switch. Switch will manage the data communication between the computers and also the router, modem, plotter, printer, fax machine, then internet connection. So all these things will be connected like same as in a building or in a campus. Then the next thing is MAN. MAN stands for Metropolitan Area Network. Metropolitan Area Network. In this, we can simply say that MAN connect multiple nearly LANs. If we have two or three buildings, which is nearly situated, and we can connect the LANs available in these three buildings together. That is known as Metropolitan Area Network or MAN. You can see the example in the screen. Office building is there. Then a residential area is there. Some government buildings are there. University campus is there. So these everything is connected with the same thing. That is known as a Metropolitan Network. Metropolitan network, and we can easily say that the connection of network in a larger geographical area than LAN. So LAN means a few kilometers or not more than a mile, but in the case of MAN, it is bigger than LAN. So a group of LANs can be handled using MAN. And also it can also be considered as a large computer networks that usually spans a city or a very large campus like our university, Calicut University. It's a large campus actually. So we can connect all these things using the network MAN, Metropolitan Area Network. MAN, Metropolitan Area Network. Then it is a few kilometers at high speeds and also owned by some single organizations and all. Then we have the third item, that is WAN, 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 Wide Area Network. Wide Area Network. It is also named like Extended Network. It is huge than LAN, than MAN and all. You can see here the example. We are connecting a centralized voice, then third party vendors, internet, VPN, some buildings are the redundant voice, data center, everything. Everything is coded inside the same image. You can see this. And the wide area network connect multiple LAN to one another over great geographic distances. So we can handle a great distance in WAN. That is, it covers a large geographic area such as a country, a continent, or even a whole world. So it is a larger thing. To cover great distances, WANs may transmit data over high-speed phone lines. And also, we can use wireless links such as satellite. You have here the word satellite. So we can make use of the satellite also in the case of WAN. WAN. And in WAN, multiple LANs or MANs can be connected together using networking devices such as bridge, router, gateways and all. So in our area also we can connect in this area, like in this MAN. So a WAN means we are managing multiple MANs. MANs, like we are handling a large area. Then the networking devices. What are the networking devices we are using? Bridge, router, modem, switch, hub. Then all these things are coming under the category network devices. To connect the computers in a network, networking devices are used. The type of devices used will depend on the type of network and also the way of computers are connected in the network. So let us discuss what are they. Just brief it, the devices used to connect computers in a network are called network devices. Okay, then we can go to the categories. Common devices are network interface card, routers or switches, gateways, repeaters or hub, bridges, modem, wireless access point. So what do you mean by network interface card? A network interface card is a computer hardware component which allow you to connect the computers and also to communicate over a computer network. So whenever you are communicating over a computer network, it is allowed only when your NIC is okay. NIC. Network interface card. You can see the example for NIC here. D-Link NIC. Ethernet port is there. This is the connection point which you can see. Then PCI connection is available there. It is just looking like our RAM pin. RAM. Random access memory pin. Then we can have the example for router. Router or switch. Router or switch. Actually, it is used to connect two or more computer networks that use the same protocol. What do you mean by the protocol actually? If we are okay with the internet, we are getting the result from internet. It is possible only if you are using some protocol in your system. Actually, we don't need to choose that protocol. It will automatically come to you. Transmission control protocol, internet protocol, like all these will come to you automatically whenever you are searching for something. If you are taking your Google Chrome and you are typing simply YouTube, after loading your YouTube, just go and check what is your URL right now. It will be just like www.youtube.com. But you just typed YouTube itself. So it will automatically pin the protocols to your searches. Then this is the connection device which is connecting two or more computer networks together. You can see the router, router A, router B, router 3. This is a device which is familiar to you. And the next point is gateway. Gateways are the devices on and also known as the servers which connect two or more network that use different protocol. In the case of router or switches, we are connecting some devices in the network. If that devices are using same protocol, but in the case of gateway, we are connecting the devices in the network which is using different protocol. Different protocol. And also we can simply say that, guys, gateways means it will protect your system. If any kind of, so you can see the repeaters hub. In the case of repeaters or hubs, repeaters are used within a network to extend the length of communication. If we can communicate much more time, that is only happened with the help of repeater. And hubs are basically multi-port repeaters. Next is bridges. Bridges are used to connect similar network segments. It allows computers on either segment to access resources on the other. And also they can used to divide large network into smaller network. So it will connect the similar network segments, but we can use this to divide the segments into smaller segments. You can see the example in the screen. We are using the bridges, like either bridge, and on the two sides you can have the LAN hub. This is the segmentation process taking place here. Then modem. This device is used to convert digital signal into analog signal and analog signal into digital signal. So you are using the modem to convert the signals. And also we can simplify it like the word modem stands for modulation and demodulation. Modulation and demodulation. Then the process of converting digital signals to analog signal is called modulation. And what will be demodulation? Just opposite, the process of converting analog signals to digital signal. That is the thing, demodulation. Then modems can be of internal and external. What do you mean by internal modem? Actually, it fits into expansion slots inside your computer and it is directly linked to the telephone lines through the telephone jack. It is normally less expensive than external modem. Its transmission speed is also less. So it is less expensive. Transmission speed is low. It can be connected or linked through telephone lines and the expansion slots are available inside the computer. Then the next is external modem. It is the external unit of computer and is connected to the computer through serial port. So we have the external unit portion, and also we can connect it with the help of serial port. Then it is also linked to the telephone lines through the telephone jack, same way as we are connecting the internal modem. Then these are expensive and have more operational features and high transmission speed. So you can get a high speed by using external modem. You can get more features. Then operational features are more than internal. Then it is much expensive and it is linked like same as internal modem. Then you can go to the next area, WAP, wireless access point. Wireless access point. You can see the diagram of WAP here. We are connecting the WAP with the switch. Switch is handling 4 wired PCs. Then a router is there, and also we can use the wireless PCs. So all these are connected with the help of WAP. A WAP is a point. Actually, it is a transceiver. What do you mean by transceiver? It is transmitter and a receiver at the same time. It is acting like as a transmitter and a receiver. Okay, then transceiver means transmitter and receiver. So WAP is a transceiver that broadcasts and receives signals to and from the surrounding computers. So it is acting like a broadcaster. It will receive the signals, it will pass it to the surrounding computers, and computer must have a wireless network adapter to connect through WAP. In today's laptops, you have wireless adapter which can be connected to the nearest WAP for communication. So you can connect the device to communicate with the nearest devices. Okay, then guys, you have to find the question answers. Find the answers of this questions. We have successfully completed our chapter. Then you have to go through these all questions. You have to find the answers. Answer the following questions. Then short notes. Then cross puzzle. We can discuss the question answers in the coming session also. And the crossword answers are here. Across and down answers are here. Okay, then thank you.